They say two things. They have he burned them.
He didn't just burn them. He incinerated them.
Jesus.
They were drinking like that, and they were like,
Can I ask you a question? Was Muhammad a sinner?
Everyone sins. Everyone sins.
Okay.
But there's variations of sin. A sin is a sin, brother.
There's no variation.
A sin is a sin, brother. Yeah, but you don't think
Jesus never sinned.
Where's the first?
No, you're going with assumption now. Don't go with assumption.
Okay. You're contradicting your own
thing.
You're going with assumption.
I'm going to give you the answer.
You're going with assumption.
I know more than what the Quran says.
No, I didn't say that.
What you did. Because you said that Jesus sinned, but according to your own Quran,
everyone sinned.
It's clear. Jesus did sin.
Everyone.
Why did you contradict your own Quran?
Your Quran says that Isa sinned.
Exactly.
Isa thought this.
Exactly.
And Isa is real, right?
There's no variation of sin, brother. A sin is a sin, brother.
Is it the Quran or you?
A sin is a sin. It doesn't matter.
Because when something interrupts him, it doesn't matter.
So who's right? Muhammad?
A sin is a sin. You're not God.
You. Are you going to answer the question? All people are sinful.
You're saying in a nice way.
Therefore, Muhammad, when he got a revelation from Allah, was lying about sin.
No way would I anyone
reclaim that.
No more than Muhammad. Surah 19.
Are you even a Muslim? Yes or no?
Yes.
So why would you say it doesn't matter earlier on? Why are you hiding your...
Because
he's debating you about the Quran. Use your brain.
I was even talking to this guy. Earlier, he came to talk to me. It doesn't matter, you're talking to him now.
So let's deal with this issue.
No, you grant me to speak to you privately.
No matter what, you're talking to me now.
Okay.
Where's the love of Jesus for Sodom and Gomorrah and Moses commanded to kill?
Sodom and Gomorrah?
The Sodom Gomorrah.
The Quran condones Sodom and Gomorrah. So now you're condemning it.
No,
you're asking a question that doesn't make sense.
I didn't finish my question.
No. You said Sodom and Gomorrah. Where's the love in Sodom and Gomorrah?
Let me finish.
Your Quran can
don't. No, I get what you're saying. Look, if I heard what I said, don't ask me a silly question.
So what you're doing is you've got double standards.
If it's silly, I would interrupt you.
You're telling me you're Christian, and he's Christian, and you believe Jesus is love, and you're jumping in.
Whoa. You're talking about Sodom and Gomorrah. Now you're going somewhere else.
I don't understand about that.
Okay. Because
he jumps up people. He's talking about Allah now.
I'm going to put the Bible or Christianity as a standard.
Jesus,
but then your own Quran affirms.
And you're telling me Jesus is
all. Exactly.
So that's why you're all over the place.
Exactly.
This is what confused Muslims.
Exactly.
What I'm saying is this.
So anyway, are we going to look at this?
I'm asking a silly question. Why is he shouting first of all?
Are we going to look at Surah 19?
How was he chanting these guys? Or chanting that lady in the balloon?
Surah 19.
And he went, I'm
just going to privately. Should we see what Surah 19 says?
Okay, so it says, I am only a messenger from your Lord to announce to you the gift of a righteous son. So he's reading your Quran, man. Respect, man.
You don't care about his Quran. You don't want to know about your Quran, do you?
Sir, are you scared?
You don't care about
your Quran. Are you
scared, sir?
Should we read your Quran? You said that all people sin. So are we going to go to your parents?
He doesn't want it. He doesn't understand the Quran. Okay, show us the sin of Jesus then.
The difference is, all the prophets are forgiven the future sin. Even if you think something
is sin. Sir, you're saying something garbage. Show us what Jesus said. Prove yourself.
Are you Christian?
I am a Christian. Prove it.
You're following forces.
Prove it then.
I am.
Okay, go on.
Where's the original Hebrew?
Where? is Jesus' sin? Yes.
He asked me to prove it.
Where is Jesus' sin? Go on. Where's the proof?
Where's the original Hebrew?
You don't need to cover your face. Are you scared?
Why don't you film yourself as well?
Are you scared?
Film yourself.
I can't film myself.
You can turn the camera.
Fuck is that?
I'm not going to film myself.
Why not?
Because when I want to, I will.
Yeah. But you see, you don't want to turn the camera to you.
So you don't have the proof, yeah?
I don't want to be filmed. So you don't want to be filmed.
You don't want to be filmed. You don't want to be filmed.
You don't want to be filmed either.
Come on. I never said I don't want to be filmed.
You don't want to film yourself.
This is Speaker's Corner.
Yeah, not filming.
Everybody. Yes. Everybody. If you're here, you're going to be filmed.
I can say nicely. Don't you say safe.
No, you don't have a proof.
No, he's safe.
You can say it nice if you want.
I asked some other
things. I'm always on video. Show us a proof where Jesus said.
So what's the question?
Where Jesus said.
Yeah,
where Jesus actually said. He said Jesus is a sinner.
Yeah, so where Jesus said. According to Quran.
Can I ask you? Your name Godwin, yes? 1 minute.
What's your name?
John Doe. Yeah? So I'm going to give you one.
He was a joker.
That just sounds.
John Doe. Jane Doe.
Jane Doe.
Female.
Is that a real name?
It's everything.
That's what I'm laughing. Because I can tell you made it up. And this is the problem with Muslims. They lie and they make things
up. They lie and deceive.
And where does that come from?
No, because Allah is a liar.
20 years.
No, Allah is a liar. Allah is a liar.
When they say that, what's my name now?
Okay, now give us the proof.
They can't tell you my name.
John Doe. Give us the proof now.
John Rambo.
No, you said John Doe, John Rambo, and then John.
Jay Smith.
Tell us your real name.
The Muslim version.
So can you show me how to interpret the Quran?
Okay, so just let me finish for 1 minute. So in the Quran, Allah says to Muhammad, that your future sins and your past sins are forgiven.
No, we're talking about Jesus.
All the prophets.
We're talking about Jesus. What?
What? Did you hear him?
No, he answered a question. That's a silly answer.
No,
he said it applies to all the prophets.
So he spoke to Moses.
Are you doing your own tafsir?
But somehow it applies to all the prophets.
You said about Jewish prophets.
You just said.
You just said that you're on camera, brother.
Give a chance.
Yeah.
Your future and your past sins are forgiven.
And then that applies to all prophets.
But he still wait. Can I say?
You said that applies to all prophets.
How does that apply to sincerity? You say
John Doe. John Rambo. You're lying.
One minute. I asked to speak for 1 minute. I spoke for 20 seconds. You jumped.
You're asking the question.
And I but I can ask 10 questions. If you can come back and ask one question only. By my
no, we asked you.
No, you didn't answer.
You answered. Okay. And now we respond.
John Rambo.
Don't try to
take 1 minute. Okay.
John Rambo.
I'm going to say this. Let me say this. I'm going to speak for 1 minute. I may ask the question, but don't answer.
All right. 1 minute. Go on. Go on. 1 minute.
So we've asked you a question. Are you going to respond to that question?
I did already.
Where Jesus said.
Let me finish.
Okay, continue what you said.
Allah says in the Quran, Muhammad says to them, your sins, future and past are forgiven. But what I'm trying to say is the point is this. So, the Quran says, I'll repeat it. That Allah said to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, your future past is all forgiven.
Okay.
However, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is so beautiful in nature. He wants to show you how to repent. So every day he repented. More than us, 100 times a day he said astaghfirullah. Even though his wife came to him and reminded him, why do you say astaghfirullah? Why do you ask for forgiveness when Allah has forgiven you already your future? He said, am I not to be dutiful to my Lord and be grateful that I should not be pleased and happy for him, to him who created me?
You got 20 seconds.
20 seconds. Okay, so what we've asked you is,
Exactly. We're talking about Muhammad.
We're talking about how Muhammad was asking
for sin. Come on, bro. John Rambo. You're rambling about, man.
Let me read the verse that you're referring to. In Surah 97, so not all Muhammad said, none has the right to worship Allah. And ask forgiveness for your sin and also for the sin of the believing man, your moving heart and your peace of rest. So he's speaking about Muhammad, that's the verse.
Okay, so if you just sin forgiven and pass it, there's a verse later.
We asked you about Jesus, not Muhammad, to start with.
But the point is, my friend, we asked you about Isa.
What about Jesus?
We asked you about Isa. Now the problem we have here is your Quran says that that Isa is righteous, sinless, faultless. Okay, right? But in the Quran, it never calls Muhammad righteous, sinless, false. Okay? So you have a righteous man.
No need. Don't create your own tafsir, please. It's your own tafsir. We don't need your own tafsir.
Who's a sinful man?
We don't need your own tafsir.
So the question is, who do you follow?
Exactly.
Do you follow the righteous man?
Uh-huh.
Or do you follow sinful
man. Uh-huh.
Okay. And so,
uh-huh.
I,
no, you don't have an answer.
We already answered that question. And the problem is,
we already answered that question. It doesn't matter.
Muhammad
no, we answered already.
Okay.
Wait, hold on.
Okay. First of all, we know everything about Muhammad's life since then. We know from his birth to his cruelty, his revelation, to his death. We don't know everything about Jesus, first of all, from A, when he's there's a year period, don't lie. Do not lie.
Does Allah
what's your point? We don't know about Jesus.
You know your child.
Allah made the statement.
No, wait, talk to us.
Wow.
What's
righteous.
Your point?
1 minute, yeah,
Allah made the statement.
No, no, we want to know your point. No, but we don't want to know your point.
But he's saying we don't know about Islam.
You know when you're trying to say something?
What is your point? What's your point?
So my point, if you let me finish, you would be saying it doesn't matter. You would be
what's
saying,
your point?
My point is this. When you were a child, you'll go through hormonal change. When you're fat, there's no need to science approving it. It's what they call the ADHD for some people.
Keep talking.
Wow, 20 seconds, you know what I mean?
Keep talking.
When I do this to him, he...
Hey. Don't be victim mentality. Victim mentality.
Answer the question. Why can't you just let
you're
me
the one who's emotional.
Why are you narrating?
Why are you so emotional?
Why are you narrating? Why are you commenting?
He's calm.
Don't comment.
He's calm.
Why are you talking?
John Rambo. Answer the question, please. No, that's your name.
He went on a rampage.
John Rambo. Then you can go.
No, you can go. I'll say first.
No, we're at Speaker's Corner.
So, the question that you want me to answer, you say no one can answer. The problem is, you're not going to get the answer because when we try to talk,
we're not going to get the answer.
I'm going to say one minute I'm asking for. What's that? Give me 1 minute. Yeah? So, when he's a child, you're a child. You go through hormonal changes when you're about 13, 14, 15. It's called adolescent stages.
Is it?
When you rebel.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I like your little comment. For a Christian, it's not going to do.
Uh-huh.
But anyway, you know, like, you go through. Like, Mom, I'm not going to do that for you now. You're going to be rebellious.
Why is he giving us garbage lecture?
There's a gap. There's a 12-year gap.
What does that got to do with sin?
I don't know.
Where did you go?
That
got
nothing to do with sin.
You're talking about teenagers.
You're talking about baby Jesus.
You'd be little.
What was
that? Maybe stepping into some
things.
Maybe. Where's your proof, man? Where's your proof? We don't go with maybes here.
God forgave Jesus.
Yeah. No, you don't need a minute, man. We can't even give you a second.
What's the point that you're okay, so, Jesus, so the question we're asking is, what does the Quran say? According to the Quran, Surah 19, it says that Jesus was, or Isa, is righteous, is sinless.
Different
interpretation. According to the Quran, Surah 47, and also Surah 48, it says that Muhammad was a sinner. So if we're asking him, what does the Quran actually say about it? Because the point we're making is that if you choose to follow the righteous man or the sinful man over the righteous man, okay, then what happens when both of their statements contradict each other?
Exactly.
You have to choose the one who's sinless, because of course they did not lie. And so now he's going to adolescence and when he was young and teenagers.
What does that got to do with sin?
What has that got to do with sin? So the question again.
Typical Muslim.
Welcome to Islam.
John Rambo.
Welcome to the religion of Muslim.
I don't know. No answer.
So you have no answer.
No answer. No answer. You're talking about adolescence. We're talking about sin. You're talking about adolescence. Use your brain, man.
Okay.
My lord!
Well, you know it's ridiculous.
Ridiculous, man.
Well, you know what? You're not forgetting.
You get what I'm saying.
What's his point?
He's trying to say that you don't know the exact details of Jesus' life, from when he was born to when he was older, when he was younger. So he's saying, if you don't know it fully, then how can you say that he did sin or he didn't do sin? How can you say that?
I'm going to deal with what you just said. So remember what
that's his point. What was his question?
We can deal with that easily. Go for it.
What was his question?
Our response to that was, we may not know, or he may not know, But who does know? According to you, Allah knows, right? Okay? So according to the Quran, which Allah apparently revealed to Muhammad, it says in Surah 19:19, that this man was faultless.
Exactly.
And then when you go into the hadith, it goes on further. It speaks about Maryam and Isa as faultless. So we know throughout his life he was sinless.
Yes.
And so we do, you do, well, according to Islam, Muslims, they will be able to affirm that he was sinless, regardless of whether they know every single detail of his life.
Yes.
And that's the point we're making to him.
Yes.
So all the adolescents...
Yeah, do you get that? Do you get that?
Does that make sense?
Yeah, okay. It makes sense to you, though. That's good.
Like you're arguing over.
He doesn't understand.
You're both agreeing on the same point, but you're not really.
Not really.
But yeah,
I think it's interesting. You're not
arguing. No, but we need a proof of what Jesus said in Islam.
Yes.
Don't give us his adolescence that doesn't exist.
You can't say he's sinless.
To us, anyway.
You have no proof.
So you
just reject
it. What do you mean? It says in the Quran.
I'm trying to prove this.
John.
I'm trying to say this. All the prophets, the sin that Jesus said, the sin to us, this is the problem. Say this tree had apple
and I stole it and it was someone's garden. We would nowadays wouldn't think that's stealing, that's not that much.
Okay.
But back then, a prophet, if they took that, they would feel so guilty.
Jesus is sinless, man.
They're nuts are different. So any prophet, if they did sin, we don't know if Jesus was sinless. But even if, look. He asked this question, what's your point? And I'm trying to give my point, he just keeps talking and talking. And his buddy, they're like commenting because he's the audio of the camera.
Okay.
Doesn't want to film himself, but likes to be the narrator.
Did you finish?
No, so what I'm trying to say is this. You know what? This guy who writes is not
perfect. Sinner or sinless? Sinner or sinless?
We don't know. You can't say Jesus is sinless.
So you reject your Quran?
Your Quran says it.
You reject your Quran.
Can I finish?
No, you can't finish.
You reject your Quran.
Your Quran says it.
And I will finish.
Your Quran says it.
Regardless of sinning or not, God forgave them.
You reject
your Quran. What are you talking about, man?
I have to go up.
God forgave them.